Your Excellency, Mr. Volkan Bozkir, President of the United Nations General Assembly, Excellencies, distinguished delegates to this high-level meeting, fellow citizens. It is an honor to be invited to speak today, and I do so as one of the many voices that have participated in the global civil society event organized by hashtag WeThePeoples2020 on September 26th, the International Day for the Total Elimination of Nuclear Weapons. Along with the severe impact of the COVID-19 global pandemic, we are also confronted by a planetary emergency. A perfect storm brews in the horizon with the devastating impacts of climate change, disasters, and extreme weather events, alarming loss of biodiversity, looming food insecurity, rising water stress, unprecedented pressure on oceans, and the unsustainable use of resources. It can thus be easy to forget that the nuclear arms race and unresolved conflicts between nuclear armed states pose a grave danger to humanity. The nuclear menace is growing as some countries build up their nuclear capabilities and others are withdrawing from arms control efforts, whether it is through escalation of conflict, malicious intent, or even miscalculation. A nuclear war continues to be a possibility. Nuclear weapons are the most inhumane and indiscriminate ever created, and the extreme destruction caused by them cannot be limited to military targets or combatants. In the words of President Ronald Reagan, a nuclear war cannot be won and must never be fought. This is what makes today's event even more significant. The elimination of nuclear weapons is, after all, a core responsibility of member states of the United Nations, arising from the very first UNGA resolution adopted by consensus on January 24, 1945. This obligation has been reinforced by numerous UN resolutions since then, and also by the 1969 Non-Proliferation Treaty, the Treaty on Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons of 2017, and the 2018 UN Human Rights Committee General Comment 36 on the right to life. If we pause and reflect for a moment, nuclear weapons are of no use in the face of a pandemic, or for our quest to protect the climate, our responsibility to feed the hungry, ensure healthcare, education, and basic services for all, leaving no one behind and fortifying our planet, the only home we have. Indeed, nuclear disarmament will free up much needed resources to address instead these genuine human security issues and needs, USD 100 billion per year to be precise, which is used to maintain, modernize, and deploy nuclear weapons. We all have a key role to play and engage with governments to ensure implementation of nuclear disarmament obligations and in diverting resources from nuclear weapons to positive impacts for the economy, livelihoods, and protection of nature. Parliamentarians for Nuclear Non-Proliferation and Disarmament have been working closely with the Interparliamentary Union, the global organization of national parliaments, to realize a nuclear weapons-free world. In 2014, a comprehensive resolution on nuclear disarmament was adopted, and a parliamentary plan of action to implement this followed soon thereafter. Key actions undertaken by legislators in nuclear-armed and allied states include cutting nuclear weapons budgets, supporting key non-proliferation and disarmament agreements, and promoting nuclear risk reduction measures such as diplomacy, detente, de-alerting, and declarations to never initiate a nuclear war, i.e. no first use policies. In non-nuclear states, actions include the adoption of strong nuclear prohibition legislation, an end to public investments in the nuclear weapons industry, support for establishment of additional nuclear weapons-free zones, and for signing, ratifying, and implementing the Treaty on the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons. Legislators from around the world are also joining civil society calls on governments to commit to the total elimination of nuclear weapons by 2045. The 100th anniversary of the United Nations. As the world prepares to recover from COVID-19 and hit the reset button in charting a sustainable path forward and building back better, we appeal to all governments to support and implement these calls. Thank you.